Welcome to r/Tales from Retail, where we share stories of your bosses, employees, or those interesting customers you see daily. And the first story is, it worked perfectly before, now it doesn't. So I receive a phone call from a customer asking if we're able to take his bike apart completely so he can get the frame and forks resprayed, then rebuild it again. I tell him this is no problem, and we would just charge him for a full service. I actually went in too low with the price here, as it's a fair amount more work than a regular full service, but it doesn't really matter too much. He got lucky with price today. We discuss a few details, and he says he will bring the bike in, which he does. We go over the details. We will disassemble. He will take the frame and forks away to be resprayed to a friend of his who does respraying, then bring them back to us as soon as he can so we can reassemble it and service it. All good so far. I immediately go to work disassembling the bike and give him a call to tell him it's ready. He comes to collect the frame and forks, pays for the entire job in advance, and leaves us with the bits and pieces. The next day, someone else comes up to the door with his frame and forks, resprayed, and hands them to me, telling me he's been sent to drop these off. I say thanks and take them in. Before I start reassembling his bike, I inspect the paint job, which I am not impressed with at all, and then I notice a problem. On one of the tubes of the frame, there's an area about the size and shape of a pencil that hasn't been painted properly. As in, I can still see the old color underneath quite clearly. It looks stupid, actually, and very, very obvious once it's pointed out. This area is on the inside edge of the tubing by the back wheel, so you wouldn't necessarily see it easily when the bike was built up. But I did not want to build his bike up for him to want it resprayed when he noticed. I decided I had no choice but to phone him and just tell him about it before I did anything. The call goes like this. Me: hi, you brought your bike for the frame to be sprayed, blah, blah, blah. Customer: oh yeah, hi, did they bring the frame in? Me: yes, but there's a potential problem in that there's an area on the frame that hasn't been painted properly. It's about the size and shape of a pencil on the inside edge of one of the tubes. Customer: what do you mean? Me: there's an area on the frame where you can still see the old color and graphics showing through. Customer: what? Where? How bad is it? Me: it's on the inside edge of one of the tubes, chainstay, and it's quite noticeable once you see it. If I were you, I would definitely take it back and get them to spray over it. I just wanted to call you and tell you before I built it up, so you could get it fixed. Customer: so what should I do? Is it really bad? Me: look, I don't know whether it's going to bother you, but if it was me, I would take it straight back. Why don't you come down and have a look at it? Customer: this is annoying. Shall I phone them? Me, laughing a little: if I were you, I wouldn't even do that. I'd just turn up with it and show them. Am I right in remembering that you said it's a friend of yours? Customer: yes, a friend of mine works there. I'm going to phone them and see what they say. Me: okay, well, let us know what you want us to do. We'll just wait to hear from you. Call ends. A few minutes later, the phone rings and I answer. The call goes like this. Me: good afternoon, store intro, blah, blah. ASP: angry sounding person. I hear you got a problem with the frame we did? Me: oh, are you the people who sprayed the frame for Mr. Customer? ASP: yeah, what's the problem you have with it? Me: we don't have a problem with it. I was just pointing out to the customer that the frame hasn't been sprayed properly and... ASP: what do you mean? Me: well, there's an area of the frame about the size and shape of a pencil that hasn't been sprayed over. ASP: where? What do you mean not sprayed over? Me: I can still see the old color and graphics in a small area of the frame where the new paint hasn't been applied. I'm the guy who has to put this back together, and I don't want to put it together only to be told to take it apart so it can be resprayed again. ASP: well, it's up to him, isn't it? What does he want us to do? Me: I have no idea. I'm just waiting to be told what to do by Mr. Customer. ASP: well, if he wants us to do it again, he'll have to let us know, won't he? Me: yeah? Call ends. The phone rings about 30 seconds after that last call ends, and this time it's the customer. Customer: did they call you about the frame? Me: yes, I just spoke with them. Customer: what did they say? Me: they wanted to know where they haven't sprayed properly and what you want them to do about it. Customer: shall I just get them to do it again? Me: I think you should come here and look at the frame, so you can see exactly what I'm talking about and decide from there. Customer: well, you said it's quite bad. I'm gonna call them again and get them to respray it. Call ends. So now I get to sit down and have a break from phone calls that go in circles, but my rest is rudely interrupted, about half an hour later, by a man who I had never seen before, barging into the store in a right huff, and loudly exclaiming, "Where's this frame you got a problem with then?" I get the frame and show him. On seeing the area I've been talking about all this time, he instantly changes attitude and calms down, saying, "Oh yeah, yeah, that's definitely not right. Yeah, that's our fault. We'll sort that out, no problem. Sorry, blah, blah." He takes the frame and leaves. Phone rings. I wish that my glare had the power to silence that D phone. Customer, have they collected the frame? Me, yes, they're going to respray it. Customer, what did they say? Me, they said it wasn't right. They'll sort it out and he took it away. Customer, okay, cool. Call-ins. So the next day the frame is dropped off by the paint man and he proudly shows that everything is fine now. I'm not sure if I'm meant to be impressed that it took them 2 attempts, but whatever. I take it in and start to reassemble the bike. This is unfortunately where things go wrong. So as I'm assembling the bike, I realize there's another issue. I'm about to put the sealed bearings in the head tube, where the forks go through the frame, and the bottom bracket, where the pedals go through the frame, but whoever sprayed the frame didn't mask anything off. So there's paint inside the tubes, where the bearings drop into, headset, and actually press into with a bearing press, in the case of the bottom bracket. With his particular bottom bracket standard, the shell of the frame and the bearings have a tolerance of 0.02 millimeters. In other words, it's a very tight and precise fit. I decide to ring the customer because there's a high chance that the paint will flake off around these areas when I press the bearings in. Me, the guy who did your frame didn't mask off anything, so there's paint inside all the tubes where we need to press the bearings back in, and the paint is almost definitely going to flake a little around these areas when I put them in. Customer, why? What do you mean? Me, explains in detail. Customer, okay, just do it and see what happens. I'll come and collect it tomorrow. Me, no problem. Call-ins. So I press the bearings in, and as expected a small amount of paint flakes off, but actually not as much as I was expecting. It's hardly noticeable. I then start to put all the other components back on, and realize the following. The front chain rings and chain are worn, and ideally need replacing. The larger front chain ring is bent a little. The chain is too long. The rear cogs are worn out as well as rocking side to side on the part they're meant to be solidly attached to, which is also worn out and in need of replacing. The front derailleur, gear changer, is significantly bent and twisted. The gear cables are a bit rusty and not moving freely. I replace the gear cables and a few other minor parts, including shortening the chain. Total is 20-something, and do the best I can with what he has. He comes back to collect the bike the next day and seems happy. I tell him I changed the gear cables, etc., and it's 20-something extra to pay. He doesn't mind this, and just as he's about to pay, I start to question whether he's aware that a lot of parts are worn and in need of replacing. He says no very abruptly and wants to know exactly which parts. I go to the bike and point out all the stuff that's wrong. He informs me that it's been running perfectly, and he uses it every day. I tell him that we've done the best we can with it without spending too much, but he should be changing all these parts. He now wants to test the bike all of a sudden, so he leaves all his stuff on the counter and takes it outside. He rides it around briefly and comes back. Customer, the front gears won't change, and the back ones are all over the place. At this point, my boss replies and decides to take over. Boss, well, as Mr. 114 has pointed out to you, all the gears are worn out and in need of replacing. Customer, but it worked fine before. Boss, well, bring it in and I'll have another look at it. We have another look. My boss tweaks a few things and gets him to try it. He rides around the front and comes back. Customer, it's no better. The gears aren't working properly. What's going on? Boss, there isn't much else we can do to it. It's all set correctly, but everything is worn. Customer, well, it worked fine before. Boss, it can't have worked fine before. Look at the gears. Customer, well, you must have done something to it. Boss, we haven't done anything to it. We've taken your bike apart and put it back together. Customer, well, why isn't it working then? What have you done to it? Boss, nothing. We haven't made your chain too long or bent your chain ring, have we? Customer, well, I'm not having this. It worked fine before, now it doesn't work. I'm not happy. I'm not happy. What are you going to do about it? Boss, well, I can look at it again and try and adjust it some more. I don't mind doing that at all, but we can only service what you bring in, and you brought in a bike with lots of issues. Customer, you don't understand. It worked before, now it doesn't. My boss adjusts the front gears a little more again and gives it back to him. The arguing continues. Boss, try this now and see if your front gears will work. Customer, well, they better work now because this is silly, isn't it? Boss, the problem is you're trying to make all these worn-out parts run smoothly together and they just never will. No amount of adjustment is going to magically make it all like new. Customer, so what am I meant to do? Just ride around a broken bike with gears that don't work and you got my money now? Boss, this has nothing to do with the work we've done. You've paid us to strip your bike down, rebuild it, and service it. But as I said before, we can only service what you bring in. Customer, you don't get it. It worked perfectly before. I ride it every day, and I could get every gear. They both start walking to the door so he can try it again. Boss, be careful when you change up on the front now, because I've set it so the chain is getting very close to falling off the cog, to try and get it to go up for you. Customer gets off the bike. He just got on. Well, I'm not going to ride it then, am I, if the chain is going to fall off? You know what? F you. Boss, you can't take that to any bike shop in the country now in that state and get an improvement on what we've done there, unless you change parts. Customer, now walking away from the shop with his bike. F off, you idiot. Boss, well, don't come back, because you're banned. At this point, I reminded my boss that he still hadn't paid for the cables, etc. He decided to call the customer later that day and ask him to pay for them. He refused, of course, so we called the police. I can't remember the exact details, but basically the police determined that it wasn't theft for whatever reason, and wouldn't get involved. They advised a small claims court, and it's just not worth us chasing him for it. So he got away with it, unfortunately. At least it was only a small amount, I guess. The second story is, how many gallons in 2 gallons? This is the story of D's morning at work. Customer, walks through door and up to register holding a gas can. Me, hello? Customer, how much gas will a 2-gallon gas jug hold? Me, 2 gallons. Customer, no, I mean how many gallons will a 2-gallon gas jug actually hold? Me, blank stare at the customer. A 2-gallon gas jug will hold 2 gallons of gas. Customer, well, I didn't know. I'm just trying to help out a friend. Me, so you want to get 2 gallons of gas in a gas jug? Okay, what pump are you on? Customer, no, listen to me. I want to get as much gas as I can, and I have a 2-gallon gas jug. I want to put as much gas in it as it'll hold. Me, blank stare at the customer. After a minute of staring at her with nothing else going on, I guess it dawns on her what I said. Customer, oh, I get it now. A 2-gallon gas jug. 2 gallons. I've really been answering my own question with my question, haven't I? And you just repeated what I was telling you. Me, yes, ma'am. What pump would you like for me to put it on for you? Customer, the pump I'm parked on. Me, which pump are you on? Customer, I don't know. It's the one that I parked at. Me, getting really frustrated at this point. Okay, which vehicle is yours? Customer, the white one. Me, looks outside. All 4 pumps have vehicles on them, and 3 out of the 4 are white. Which white one, ma'am? There are 3 of them out there on the pumps that are white. Customer, well, the white one that's mine. Me, would you mind looking out the door and telling me which white vehicle is yours? Customer looks out the door. Oh, I see what you mean. I'm the one all the way on the far end. Me, okay, so you want 2 gallons of gas on pump 4? That'll be $4.34. Customer, $4.34 for 2 gallons of gas? Why so high? Me, gas is $2.17 a gallon. 2.17 times 2 is 4.34. This was my very first transaction after taking over the register this afternoon. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.